Yeah, yeah. Fall back too close, you ain't even know me. Trust my brothers from way back from the north. We used to be in the yard, spend it like they owe me.
Hello everyone, y'all are welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Balki. I'm a faith, fashion and lifestyle YouTube blogger and vlogger, and you are welcome. So today I have a guest here with me, Specialist Kamara, okay? He's also a Sierra Leonean. We are both Sierra Leonean people in the U.S. Army, and we're going to talk about like our experience of being Sierra Leoneans in the U.S. Army, okay? All right, so Specialist Kamara, why make you join the U.S. Army? Why make you not join Salon Army?
I don't know if you want to let me put on a Creole.
We can do both.
So, actually, I joined the U.S. Army because I was fortunate to come to the United States.
Okay.
And yeah, I had it on my plan. Like, when I get to the United States, I'm going to join the Army.
Okay.
But initially, when I was in Sierra Leone, back home in Africa, like two times, I tried joining the Sierra Leone Armed Forces. I tried two times. But I don't know. Probably it's different over there. You know where we meet, you and I are coming from.
Okay.
I tried joining the Army over there. Did my application and everything. So when you do application over there to join the Army, you gotta wait, and then you get shortlisted, and then you go to training. So on two occasions, two different occasions, I think my application was turned down because everything is like, who knows you, like connection, you know, sabi, just like that is it. So, and then I had to drop it, and then when I was working on my program to come to the U.S., and then when I came to the U.S. and said, okay, I think I can still, like, pursue my dream because I had it in the back of my mind saying, I'm going to join soldier. And then I started the processing. Here I am.
I didn't even know you tried to join, you know, the armed forces in Sierra Leone, because they didn't take them serious, you know. African military, they're always so very much insulted. People insult them a lot. So yeah, well, for me, I just needed something new, something different. You've heard me say that before. I just needed to get out of the civilian life, you know. Like, I'm not used to, I'm not new to the military family per se, but I'm new to being a soldier, you know. So I just wanted something different, something different. So what's the, like, the best thing about joining the U.S. Army? What do you think it is? Like, what's the best thing?
So one of the best things, so you have to take, you know what they call the ASVAB? Like, it's an entrance. That's one of the best things.
Okay.
Yeah, they evaluate you. You have to know how to read. You have to know how to write. You have to know a little bit basics, like, mathematics and other stuff. You know, so I was like, oh, okay. And, you know, when I first met my recruiter, and then he told me. And then he had a little room in the back of the office. I had to go do a little test. and then when I went home, I was like, oh, okay, it's different over here. You know, so yeah, that's a great thing. It's just and then when I went to basic training, the way of training is a little bit different. Like, here they be yelling at you, you know, those drill sergeants be yelling. But yelling can do anything to me. You know where we come from? Moms or dad just yell. So I was like, oh, that's nothing, you know. Waking up early, you know, small meal, you know, keep your
business. Jollof rice. I miss that during training.
For 10 weeks.
Yes, like, you will lose so much weight, because for me, African food, they make her add weight. Like, it makes me add weight a lot. I lost 12 pounds while I was in training. How many pounds did you
I didn't even check.
You didn't check?
Oh, I knew I dropped. I wasn't checking. No pounds, nothing.
So, you know? it was tough. Like, so what's the bad part? Like, what would you say the cons are of joining the Army? Like, is there anything you regret or you don't like about the Army, you know? just based on your own experiences?
Well, I'm still in the army anyway, so I'm still learning things. Still learning. You know, yeah. I'm still trying to put the puzzles together.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, try to separate what I like mm-hmm. from what I don't like.
Right.
You know, although there are things that I have experienced that I don't like, but I'm still looking at it like probably maybe it's going to change, you know, because I'm still down the line. I'm just a specialist and I got more steps to go.
Right.
So the more I go, probably I'm going to meet new things. And then I'm going to put them together and say, oh, what I was thinking is right, or what I was thinking is wrong, you know. So for now, I just put that on a pause, you know.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Like, it's just about, oh, they say the U.S. Army is what you make of it.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you come in with a plan, with a goal, you'll be fine. You know, me too. I'm still learning. I'm a specialist in the army. I'm still learning, and some of even the negative things, I see them as a positive thing and a learning experience, you know.
Yeah.
I've been a civilian, I work with all type of people, so I know how to like handle certain situation by God's grace. But you know, we're still learning. So what advice will you give anyone trying to join the military? Maybe a Sierra Leonean, a non-Sierra Leonean, I don't know, someone not born in America, someone born in America, like what type of advice would you give anyone coming in?
So, joining the army in the U.S., you got to put your mind to it. Yeah, you have to focus.
Yeah, absolutely.
You have to have a full-time devotion. Mm-hmm. Like, what I mean is, if you decide to join the army, you got to think about changing location. And you can be sent anywhere at any time.
Yeah.
So you have to be ready for that. You have to be strong enough for that.
Yeah.
You don't have to be like a crybaby. You don't have to be worried like, oh, this is going to happen, that is going to happen. Anything happens, right? But that's why you sign.
Yeah.
You know, that's why you sign the paper like, oh, I'm signing, I need to join the army. It's not about just wearing the uniform. People see the uniform on you and like, oh, he looks good or she looks good in the uniform. It fits you. Oh, you know, people just look at those things and admire them. Or, and then people see and just think like, oh, he's getting more money or this and that. But
yeah, it's deeper than that.
It's deeper than that. You know, it's deeper than that.
Yeah.
That's why you have a whole lot of things that come with the army, like benefits that come with the army.
Right.
So you have to be ready for it. You don't look at the money, you know.
Yeah.
You can get paid today. Get it done tomorrow.
Yeah.
But you have to look at what comes after and how best you can make use of, you know, what comes after.
Like you said, you know, have a plan, have some type of plan. Don't just join for the money. Lots of people are joining for the bonuses.
Yeah.
And those recruiters, they're lying to people, that when you join, you get a $50,000 bonus and all that. But don't just join for the money. Join for like other reasons. You can join for school, you can join to travel, you can join to meet people, and like it's a great experience. And if you have the opportunity, I will advise anyone who has the opportunity to, you know, join and see what you can make of it.
One of the
advice I got was, if you don't like it anymore, leave.
Wait for your turn. If you are doing a 4 years, after your 4 years, say, hey, I'm tired.
You're tired.
Full uniform.
You
put
can
it
leave.
Down, sign
go to
up.
My first. So you don't need for stay.
You don't need for stay forever. You know,
you don't need for stay
it's
forever.
Up to you.
Yeah.
The option is there with you. You
exactly.
sign the contract for 4 years, 5 years.
Uh-huh.
When your time done, you can get a flashback or you rethink. Like, from my first year to my fourth year, I'm not being joined.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to continue. Okay, no
problem.
Put the uniform, tell and say, attire. Nobody not going to go force you. You know what I mean?
Go back to salon. You know, no one is keeping you. You're not stuck, basically. You're not stuck.
Yeah.
You're not. So would you, as a special, would you plan to go to officer school, OCS?
Yes, I've been talking to people.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so basically, I'm talking to different people. Like, people in the army from...
Mm-hmm.
From Sierra Leone, that are in higher ranks, like enlisted ranks or officer ranks.
Yeah,
I'm talking to them, and even talking to people from other countries that you know, trying to know the best way how to go about it. I like it. I want to go officer school.
Okay,
you know,
that'll be awesome.
You know, so it's like having I don't have a degree, so it's like I can't just go like straight to OCS like that.
Yeah.
You know, you have all the process, have to turn in paperwork, they have to approve you, and then if you are approved, and then you leave the work and then go to school, and then from there and then go to
office school.
Yeah.
For me, I know my dad wanted me to go straight in as an officer, but you know, first of all, I didn't want to just come in, you know, so position of leadership, and I don't know anything about the army basically, and then my GT score also, I have to like increase, even though I have a degree, I have to increase my GT score. In the army, you have to have a GT score of 110, huh?
Yeah.
Like 110. So if you have a GT score of 110, you're qualified for any job in the army. Right now, my GT score is 100. So if I can take that ASVAB again, increase it, then I can go to office school. So.
Yeah, that's a good thing. That's a good thing.
That's the plan. Yeah. That's the plan, okay? Give me your prayer.
Yeah, but you're thinking about like going further.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what is another plan? Like, if you don't go to
officer school,
what's your other plan?
So like, definitely, I will have to go the sergeant route then. I will have to go the sergeant route. I mean, you know, it's still leadership. You know, it's still leadership. Everyone has to progress, like career progression. Like, I see myself being a sergeant first class, all of that. Master sergeant, in Jesus' name,
amen.
Commander, okay. Yeah. But yeah, like, we're just out here trying to do great things, trying to serve the United States of America. Even though we didn't get the opportunity, or we didn't make up the, how can I say, we didn't plan to, you know, well, you had planned to join the, Australian Army, right?
Yeah.
I didn't, like, Army was not in my plan, okay? Like, Army was not in my plan, but I did it, I went in, and here we are. We're going to be great, in Jesus' name.
Yeah, so you just have to, it wasn't on your plan, but now you're doing it.
Mm-hmm.
Put
your mind to it, and I'm just, you know, giving it my all, making the best of it, sharing my little, you know,
so
little advice.
One thing I learned, being in the United States Army with different people, we are all American citizens, but from different parts of the world, like, you know, you find people from Europe, Asia, Africa, just all over the
different
world.
People, yeah.
So,
yeah,
you learn different things. You learn the way how people act.
Yeah.
It's different. The way how people interpret the army.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it makes you feel down.
Yeah.
And then sometimes it like it breaks you up.
Mm.
You know.
Yeah.
So right on from basic training
mm-hmm.
to this point, I've heard a whole lot of things, like some criticizing, I made a great mistake, I'm not going to do another year, I'm not going to do another term, like another, you know, second contract or something.
Yeah.
You know, but one thing I can say is, don't listen to people, because
absolutely.
The same people
that
saying, or that were saying yesterday, and that are saying today that they are not going to do a second contract.
Mm-hmm.
Trust me,
you're
going to see them doing the second contract.
They're going to do 20 years.
Yeah. You know?
They might go to drill sergeant school too. You never know. Yeah.
So,
Like, there's a lot of negativity in the army. Like, lots of people. I remember when I just came to Georgia at the airport. So, this elderly woman saw me getting my bag, right, from the little thing that rolls your bag in, and she was like, oh, you're in the army, thank you for your service. And I was like, oh, thank you, God bless you, ma'am. And she was like, so where are you from? I'm like, Africa. And she was like, Africa? How did you join in Africa? I'm like, okay, you don't, most people in the army are not Americans, okay? Everyone in the army is not an American. Like you said, lots of people, lots of cultures, and we're like, they call us the 1%, okay? So, lots of people don't understand that the Africans in the army, they can be Asians in the army, they can be Hispanics, Italians in the army. So different people from all walks of life. And that makes the U.S. Army. And we're all here trying to fight for the country, protect the country, and do great things.
Yeah.
All right. So do you have any last words before we wrap it up?
So my last word is directly to, like, people back home that have intentions to join the army. So you should have the mindset, like what I said initially, you should have the mindset, and you should be ready for it.
Yes.
You should be ready for it. And then don't join the army because you see other people joining the army mm-hmm. and then regret later. Do it for a passion.
Yes.
Do it because you like it. Like I said, mm-hmm. I had it on a plan back home. Mm-hmm. You know, so one thing I used to admire was like, I see US soldiers, mm-hmm. by that time, mm-hmm. I was still little, see them going to Iraq.
Yeah.
Like, oh, yeah, it's fun, I want to go out there. Yeah. And even now, I still want to go out there, yeah. I still want to go out there, like, yeah. you know, whatever happens there, it happens there. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
yep,
yeah, yep. If it's combat, we do it, and then I'm just going to demonstrate what I was taught
mm-hmm.
through
mm-hmm.
basic training and yes. onward, yeah.
yeah.
So,
yeah.
Saying or thinking about I'm going to die or whatever, no, I'm not going to die.
No.
Because being in the United States Army, we are classed as the best in the world.
Yes, so, the best army in the world.
Yeah.
Yep.
So, yeah, that's what I have to say. Okay. That's my last word.
For me, I just say, you know, just do you. You know, don't listen to people. You know why you came in.
Yeah.
Be yourself. Be your authentic self. Do not let the army change you in a bad way, you know. Do not let the army make you develop bad habits. Like, let the army help you develop good habits like time management, discipline, mm-hmm. motivation, and all that. Yeah, and you'll be fine if you're onto MEPS, if you're about to go do your swearing, basic, O9 mic, wherever you're going, AIT, the Lord is with you. Just stay prayerful,
mm-hmm.
stay positive, stay hopeful, hang around the right people, and just you'll be fine. Okay,
all right,
thank you very much for
watching.
I
appreciate the time.
God bless you. Bye. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe. I will leave his socials, right? Specialist Kumara, I will leave. Tell them your social media. I will still write it on the screen. But,
which one?
On TikTok. TikTok, Facebook.
Yeah, I'm on Facebook.
Yeah.
As well. Polo,
Instagram.
Polo Man. I'm mm-hmm. on TikTok.
He's famous, yeah.
Polo Man. Yeah.
All right. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.